space race. Arms. Good morning, everyone. In the previous class, we have learned about the military alliance. Today, I would like to continue remaining topics in this lesson. Arms and space race. Arms and space race. Both the USSR and USA spent huge amounts of money to make the weapons. So they spent a lot of money, huge money, for research weapons and nuclear wars, nuclear arms, arms missiles, which could strike across the continent. So the both the USSR and USA spent huge money to make the dangerous weapons and the huge money for research weapons and nuclear arms missiles which could strike across the continents. The two countries had enough nuclear arms to destroy the entire earth many times. These two countries which have the nuclear weapons through which they can destroy the entire earth many times. Their allies like Britain, France and China also made many dangerous nuclear weapons. Their allies like Britain, France, China and other countries also developed nuclear arsenals. The competition now also extended to the space through the satellites. Use of satellites helped in directing missiles into the other target places. Now, the competition now also extended to the space. They made many dangerous nuclear weapons arsenals. At the same time, the competition was raised. Now, also extended to the space. As satellites helped in directing missiles. USSR put the first satellite, that is Sputnik. USSR put the first satellite, Sputnik, and also first USSR, the astronomer was Yuri Gagarin. He went to the space. Yuri Gagarin in USSR. He went to the space, and also the American astronomer in 1969, U.S. then Neil Armstrong stepped on the moon in 1969. USA astronomer Neil Armstrong stepped on moon. So these are the space race and arms race in between the two countries are the feel the danger of the world. Next topic, flash points. There are many moments created tension and seem to be compulsory nuclear wars between the two countries. There were many incidents took place in between the two the principal contenders, principal countries like US, in between USA and America, USSR and America. The situations took place which were leads to the Third World War, compulsory nuclear wars between the two countries. So the created tension and seemed to be the compulsory nuclear wars between the two countries, but solved problems through diplomacy. So there are some examples also here. One example, the USSR was shooting down of U-2, USA spy plane over USSR. The spy, U-2 USA spy plane was traveling over USSR. At the time, USSR was shooting down it. So that is also created tension in between USSR and USA. USSR built large quantity of missiles in Cuba was discovered. USSR built large quantity of missiles in Cuba was discovered. Means they launched huge number of missiles and weapons kept in Cuba by the US, sir. So the Cuba was near to USA, so that is feel that that is created tension in between USSR and USA. Several times during the Korean wars, Middle East wars, at the time also created tension. At the time of Afghanistan war, at the time of North Korea was adopted socialist ideas, at the same South Korea liberal democracy, American wars. So the wars has created tension in between the two countries. So those are the points about the flash points. So how the tension created in the world in between the by the USSR and USA. Next topic we are going to learn, that is non-alignment movement. Non-alignment movement is one of the important international organization was set up. So in 1950s, after the Second World War, the many countries got independence. In 1950s, the world was divided into two opponents. Means we know that after World War II, the USSR and the USA was emerged as the strong countries, the very powerful countries in the world. These two are the powerful countries in the world. So the two are having their different ideologies. That is why these two are separate group. The two countries are formed separate groups. The world was divided into two opposite camps. The rivalries between the two superpowers over military supremacy and economic supremacy. They want to keep. They want to show the military supremacy and economic supremacy in the world. The ideological conflicts lead to the establishment of bipolar world. Bipolar world means the ideologies, the two different ideologies are ideologies having the two countries. So these two are two different ideologies conflicts lead to the establishment of bipolar world. The countries who are not want to involve in the either of these two blocks, they want to establish, they want to create one international organization by newly independent countries. So the countries who are not want to involve in either of two blocks, these two they want to establish, they want to create one international organization by the newly independent countries in 1955. At Bandung in Indonesia, the first Asia-African conference was held. 29 member countries were represented in it. So, the first conference, non-alignment conference, Asia-African conference was held in 1955 at Bandung in Indonesia. 29 members were represented in that conference. So important leaders of that conference: Jawaharlal Nehru, India Prime Minister; Jawaharlal Nehru, Indian Prime Minister; Gamal Abdul Nasser, Egypt leader; Gamal Abdul Nasser, Egypt leader; Gamal Abdul Nasser, Egypt leader; Joseph Broz Tito, the leader of Yugoslavia. Nehru was acknowledged as the chief spokesperson. He was one of the main founder of NAM. NAM was established as an international organization. Its main aim to promote cultural and economic cooperation between the member countries of Asia, Africa and Latin America. So Nehru was acknowledged when he gave presidential speech. He was one of the important main leader, founder of NAM. So the Gamal Abdul Nasser, Joseph Broz Tito and Jawaharlal Nehru, these three were the important leaders at the time. So NAM was established as an international organization.
So in September 1961, the first summit meeting was held at Belgrade in Yugoslavia. It was represented by 25 member countries. In September 1961, the first summit, first meeting was held in Belgrade in Yugoslavia. First Asia-African conference was held in 1955 at Bandung. In September 1961, first summit meeting was held in Belgrade in Yugoslavia. So 25 members countries were represented in it. 25 members participated in September 1961 summit. By 2012, the membership was increased into 120 countries with 17 observers. By 2012, the members and non-arrangement members were increased into 120 countries was increased and 17 observers were found there. So in the first summit meeting, there are three major aims of the first summit: the cooperation among the member countries, reduce the growth of Cold War tension and its impact, prevent newly independent countries to join with the military bloc, cooperation among the member countries. So these three are the important aims in the first summit. So both the blocks looked at NAM was suspicious. The USSR group as well as USA group was suspected the attitudes of NAM. USA regarded the NAM as closer to USSR. USA thinking that NAM was close to USSR. NAM failed to stop wars in between their member countries. Iran-Iraq war lasting 15 or more years. Iran-Iraq war was happened so many years, but non-alignment movement has failed to stop this war. So now we are going to another topic, that is West Asian conflicts. West Asia refers to the region between Europe and Asia. West Asia area is there in between the Europe and Asia. This is also called as Middle East. West Asia is also called as Middle East. The conflicts that developed in between Arabs and Jews are called as West Asian crisis. Palestine, which was inhabited by Arabs, was under the control of Britain. Palestine means in the previous days in Palestina crisis means Palestina who were inhabited means in olden days, but previously the Jews were there, but later the Arabs mostly inhabited in Palestina. At the time the Britishers controlled the Palestina. Palestina, which was inhabited by Arabs, was under control of Britain. Their situations, Jerusalem, which is the holy city for Jews, Christians and Muslims. Jerusalem is the birthplace of the three religions, Jerusalem. So Jews, Christians, Muslims are the holy place for the Jews, Christians and Muslims also. The Jews traditionally considered Palestina as their promised land. So Jews traditionally considered that Palestina is their promised land. But Christians blamed that Jews are cause for the death of Jesus Christ. Christians blamed that Jews are cause for the death of Jesus Christ. Crucifixion. Crucifixion. The cause. Jesus Christ. Crucifixion. Caused by the Jews. That is the blamed by Christians. So a movement had developed among the Jews in the world for separate state is called as Zionist movement. Zionist movement means they want separate nation for Jews. The movement was started across the world. The Jews was demanded separate state for Jews. That movement is called as Zionist movement. What is a Zionist movement? Means the Jews were demanded separate state for Jews. The started movement is known as the Zionist movement. Jews reclaimed the Palestine as their homeland and built a separate state for Jews. Jews claimed that Palestine as their homeland and built a separate state for Jews. In 1945, this demand was supported by Western countries. But in Palestine, mostly Arab Muslims was living there. Jews were minorities at the time. Matters were complicated by the discovery of oil resources in the Middle East. At the time they found the oil resources in the Palestine. In 1947, United States passed a resolution through which Palestine was divided into two parts, Arabs and Jewish states. In 1947, United Nations Organization was passed according to the demands of the Jews. They want to make the two countries, they want to divide the Palestine into two countries, one for Jews and another part for the Arabs. In 1948, British withdrew their troops. Britishers withdrew their troops from Palestine and created new state Israel for Jews. In 1948, Britishers withdrew their troops from Palestine and created new country Israel was made for Jews. Arabs refused to recognize Israel as a country. The new Israel state government policies are very harsh against Arabs, increasing the bitterness. The new Israeli state was adopted the harsh methods against the Arabs. The Arabs were forced to leave their homes and properties, take shelter as refugees in other Arab states. So the surrounding places like Israel, the Palestine, surrounding places like Jordan, Syria, and Saudi Arabia, and Egypt, right? All countries, Turkey, all countries are the Arab countries. So the Israelis, with the help of USA, they used harsh methods and they made them dangerous weapons, and they controlled their country. Even they occupied the places of Arabs. They used a very harsh method. The Arabs were migrated from Palestine to other places due to the harsh treatment of Israel. So Egypt President Gamal Abdel Nasser made an effort to unite all the Arabs. He formed Fidayeens, suicide squads. He made suicide squads, Fidayeens means suicide squads. Egypt President Gamal Abdel Nasser made an effort to unite the Arabs. He formed Fidayeens means suicide squad. Explosions in public places in Israel. These suicide squads, Fidayeens, used by Gamal Abdel Nasser and explosions in public places in Israel. He adopted aggressive policies against Britain and France. He adopted
he adopted the aggressive policies against Britain, and France demanded that Britain should withdraw its troops from the Suez Canal. Explosions in public places in Israel. He adopted aggressive policies against Britain and France demanded that Britain should withdraw its troops from the Suez Canal. So USA withdrew its aid to Egypt for the construction of Aswan Dam. So USA withdrew its troops. USA withdrew aid to Egypt for the construction of Aswan Dam. Means the Egypt was used aggressive methods against Western countries. So they demanded to withdraw troops from Suez Canal. It demanded Britain should withdraw its troops from Suez Canal and aggressive methods against France. And USA was reacted and used to withdraw aid to Egypt for the construction of Aswan Dam. USA withdrew aid to Egypt for the construction of Aswan Dam. In 1956, Israel attacked Egypt with the support of Western powers. In 1956, Israel attacked Egypt with the support of Western powers. USA demanded to stop the war and ceasefire. They demanded to make ceasefire. Israel had to withdraw its arms. USA demanded to stop the war and a ceasefire. Israel had to withdraw its army. Later in 1967, Arabs attacked to Israel again. In 1967, Arabs attacked to Israel again. Israel re-attacked to Egypt and destroyed its entire air force base. In 1967, Arabs attacked to Israel. Israel re-attacked to Egypt and destroyed its entire air force base. Israel occupied the territories Gaza, Golan Heights and West Bank was occupied by Israel. Israel refused to return the occupied territories. Israel believed that these occupied territories would be act as a buffer zone. Israel refused to return the occupied territories. Israel believed that these occupied territories would act as a buffer zone. In 1964, PLO was established. Palestinian Liberation Organization was established by Yasser Arafat in Jordan. In 1964, PLO, Palestinian Liberation Organization, was established by Yasser Arafat. Its main aim was to regain the land it was lost. Without violence, means they want to do the non-violence method. In 1967, Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat applied pressure and forced Arab states to attack Israel. In 1967, Yasser Arafat applied pressure forced on Arab states to attack Israel. Arab states were not responded. Unsatisfied, a section of the people of Palestinian Liberation Organization under the leadership of Yasser Arafat carried out terrorist activities like plane hijackings and holding hostage the Israeli Olympic squad at the Munich Olympics in September 1972. Unsatisfied, a section of the people of Palestinian Liberation Organization under the leadership of Yasser Arafat carried out terrorist activities like plane hijackings and holding hostage the Israeli Olympic squad at the Munich Olympics in September 1972, killed many sports persons. Later, Arafat gave up terrorism and agreed to find peaceful solution. In
He made an agreement with Israel to end the long war and made many agreements regarding self-rule for Palestine. He made agreements with Israel to end the war and made many agreements regarding self-rule for Palestine. But Israel not implemented any promise and continued to attack the Palestinians. But Israel not implemented any promise and continued to attack the Palestinians. Many countries recognized PLO, Palestinian Liberation Organization, as the representative for the Palestinian state, and Yasser Arafat as its president. Yasser Arafat was recognized as its the Palestinian president, recognized as president of Palestinian Liberation Organization in 2004. In 2004, Arafat died due to suspected poisoning. In 2004, Arafat died due to suspected poisoning. The Palestinians are still fighting for their homeland and peace under very difficult conditions. The Palestinians are still fighting for their homeland and peace under very difficult conditions. So another topic, the growth of nationalism in the Middle East. The problems of Palestinians continued. Support of USA for Israel created feeling against the USA in the region. The problems of Palestinians were continued. The Arabs were faces problems due to that, created reaction in Arab countries. They opposed the USA policies. USA also became unpopular because USA supported undemocratic regimes. In this area, oil resources are available to these oil resources. They want to capture the oil resources in the Arab in the Middle East areas. So, but local common people want to use this revenue for their welfare. Revenue from the oil resources should be used for the welfare of the common people. In 1968, a revolt took place in Iraq, in which Saddam Hussein came to power with the twin slogan Arab nationalism and socialism. Arab nationalism and socialism. In 1968, a revolt took place in Iraq. Saddam Hussein came into as a president of Iraq. He raised slogans, Arab nationalism and socialism. By socialism, they want to nationalization of all resources and use the oil resources for the welfare of the people. By the socialism, they want to nationalization of all oil resources and use that revenue should be used for the welfare of the people. So later in 1969, similar development took place in Libya. In 1969, Gaddafi was established the government. In 1969, similar development took place in Libya. Gaddafi, the military officer, was established. Muhammad Gaddafi was established the government in Libya. These states made welfare policies. They implemented welfare program, welfare policies, but they used very autocratic and dictator rule. In Libya as well as in Iraq. They did not allow any opposition and democratic principles. So Libya and Iraq, they did not allow any opposition and democratic principles. So in 1979, a revolution took place in Iraq also. The old king of Iran, who was supported by USA, he lost its power. In 1979, a revolution took place. Old king of Iran, who was supported by USA, lost its power. The king rule was replaced by established no government. The king place was the king rule was replaced and established a new government which was jointly controlled by Shia Islamic and democratically elected leaders. In 1979, a revolution took place in Iran and king rule was replaced by a new government which was jointly controlled by Shia Islamics and democratically elected leaders. During the civil wars in Afghanistan, Taliban won the war and established extremist Islamic state in Afghanistan. So during the civil war in Afghanistan, Taliban won the war and established extremist Islamic state. During the West Asian crisis, Taliban come against the attacks attitude of USA. During the West Asian crisis, USA was act against the Arabs, so that the Taliban was not liked the attitudes of USA, and the Taliban come against the USA. Under the leadership of Osama bin Laden, Arab terrorists hijacked two aircraft in the USA and crashed the World Trade Center in New York. Thousands of people were killed in that incident. Under the leadership of Osama bin Laden, Arab terrorists hijacked two aircraft in USA and crashed the World Trade Center in New York. Thousands of people were killed in that incident. USA has declared war against the Taliban government. So by that attack, USA has become very angry against Osama bin Laden and Taliban. Declared war against Taliban government in Afghanistan. Eventually the war was war against Iraq. Later the hearts of fight war against Iraq. And Saddam Hussein and Osama bin Laden both were killed by USA. So I will explain later.